Today I'll show you what face culling is and how it affects performance. We are also going to measure this performance change by making an FPS counter. So face culling is a step in the graphics pipeline that decides if a triangle will move onto the fragment shader, aka if the triangle will be drawn or not. OpenGL decides this by seeing which side of the triangle is currently facing the camera. Generally speaking, in most 3D graphics programs, it is the front side of a triangle that is sent to the fragment shader and the back side of a triangle that is discarded. The way OpenGL figures out which side is which is by an index convention, which can either be clockwise or counterclockwise. In a counterclockwise framework, if the order of the indices of a triangle are counterclockwise when facing us, then the side we see is the front side. Likewise, if the order of the indices of a triangle are clockwise when facing us, then the side we see is the back side. For a clockwise framework, it's the exact opposite. Most graphic programs use a counterclockwise standard, but don't expect all of them to use this. Now, in order to put all of this into code, we just have to enable the face culling using gl enable with gl call face, specify which face we want to keep, 99% of the time that will be gl front, and then specify the standard we want to use. Again, I suggest using the counterclockwise one since from what I've seen it's more common than the clockwise one. Now, if we run the program, you'll notice that when we get inside an object, we won't be able to see its insides since it contains the backs of the triangles, which it discarded. Therefore, we only see the background. So let's see if this makes any difference in performance. For that, we'll need an FPS counter, which I'll display in the title of the window. Let's start by creating three doubles for the previous time, the current time, and the difference of these two. Then we also want an unsigned integer that will act as a counter to see how many frames we have in a certain amount of time. Now, FPS is simply the amount of frames you get in a second. So that means that in order to get the FPS, we can count the number of frames we get in a second, a frame being one loop in our main while loop. But that would also mean that our FPS will get updated only once a second. Instead, let's update it every 30th of a second, for example. To do that, we just need to get a current time in seconds using glfw_getTime, the time difference, and increment the counter. Then, if the difference is higher or equal to a 30th of a second, we go ahead with the measurement of the FPS. The FPS will simply be equal to 1 divided by the time difference, which is just the amount of frames in a second that this time difference gives, but the time difference contains multiple frames, which are equal to the counter, so we also need to multiply it with the counter as well. Now, we could stop here, but it's also useful to know how long a frame takes in terms of milliseconds. To do that, we simply divide the time difference by the counter, which gives us the number of seconds a frame takes, and then multiply that by 1000 to transform it into milliseconds. Then we simply put together the new title and apply it to the window using glfw set window title. Then we want to set the previous time as the current time in order to get the time difference back to zero and also set the counter to zero. Now if you start your program, you'll be able to see the amount of frames you have. If they are stuck on 60, then that means that you have VSync on, which tries to keep your FPS constant to 60 frames per second. If you wish to disable this, then write glfw swap interval 0 in your main function. Keep in mind that this will only be able to deactivate VSync if VSync is not forced by your graphics driver. In any case, I recommend keeping it at 60 frames per second. But if you don't want to do that, at least make sure that the functions that handle user inputs are put into an if statement that works periodically like this one. Otherwise, the responsiveness of your inputs will vary with your FPS, which you do not want. And just to show that face culling improves your FPS, here is a very high resolution model and the difference in FPS. The difference is not big here, but it's noticeable in the numbers. When you have multiple models and a lot of stuff happening, the difference will become even more noticeable. That was it for this tutorial. As always, the source code is in the description. Bye!